Hello and welcome to the 19th episode of Stories. And today I have Ms. Jyothika Shetty with me. Ms. Jyothika, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Jason. And it's really nice to be on your show. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you so much. Ms. Jyothika, before starting the show, we would like to know about you, about your life coaching, about you writing a book. Please do elaborate about your background.
Yeah, so my name is Jyothika Shetty, as you've already introduced me. And I've been a resident of Dubai for the last 27 years, and it all began with my parents living there since the 70s, actually. So effectively, my kids are the third generation who've been living there. Why I say there is because I moved to India last year after a very long time. So basically, professionally, I'm a banker by profession. For over a decade, I've been in corporate banking, okay. Followed by our own family business. We are into construction, and we run the business for the last 20 years. So my husband's a civil engineer by profession, and then he runs the business, after which I joined the business, and I manage basically the finance and administration.
Okay.
So public speaking happened to me about 7 years back. And as they say that, you know, if you're destined to do something, you're destined to do, your passion strikes in. And that exactly what happened to me.
Yeah.
During the course of my journey, I understood that I really like what I'm doing. And that's where my passion started. And in November 2018, I decided to write a book. Now, I didn't decide to write a book because I wanted to write a book. Writing is my passion, and I've been doing poems as well as short articles for many years now. Okay. So my first poem actually got published in the year 2012, and you know, it was quite liked by a lot of people. Mm-hmm. So that's what I was doing. So it was always my dream to start to write a book, and that's where my book happened in 2018. But it actually was brought into fruition, I would say, in November 2020. And finally, I'm now launched as an international author.
Nice.
Professionally or academically, I'm actually an MBA from Manchester Business School, UK, and also a certified compliance practitioner, mother of three children. And last year, I moved to India for personal and professional reasons. So again, as they say, what you're destined to do, you're destined to do. And I moved into the coaching field, which was a natural progression of what I was doing. And as a strategic life coach, what I do is I basically help people achieve their breakthroughs, move their performance to the next level by identifying those elements that actually stop them from growing or coming out of their shell. So basically, I focus on confidence and self-empowerment. Okay. Owing to my experience in leadership and public speaking, as well as an entrepreneur and a corporate banker.
Right.
So this is who I am.
Yeah, and I think along the course of time, life goals are very important for a person. And working on the life goals is a very critical thing. I think you are doing a great job. I think that's the strategic life coach's duty, I think. Working on the life goals.
I guess so. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Would you like to elaborate how did you manage your success, and like you would have a success statement with you, so or success strategy? Would you like to share with our audience today?
Well, Jason, to be honest, I wouldn't really like to categorize myself into those people who have a success statement and all of that, because mm-hmm. the definition of success statement is different for each one of us.
Correct.
And for me, it was purely being a lifelong learner.
Nice.
And that's what I truly believe in. And if it was not that, I wouldn't have completed probably my MBA after I crossed my 40. So now you know my age. And for me, learning never stopped. And one thing I very strongly and firmly believe in is that be your best in whatever you do.
Yes.
My dad used to say, if you're a sweeper, be the best sweeper. If you're doing anything, try to do your best. Because when you honor your own job, what you're doing, you can always aim to move to the next level.
Yeah.
But most of the time, what happens to us is we're not satisfied with what we are in the current position. And we aim at doing bigger things.
Correct.
For me, it all starts with today. So two things that are very close to my heart is be a lifelong learner and be the best in whatever you do.
That's great. If we talk about challenges, obviously, there would have been a lot of challenges associated on this journey. Would you like to throw some light on the challenges, and how did you overcome those?
My simple answer to this question, which is a very good question, is please read my book. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to market my book here, but please read my book, because my book talks a lot about the challenges that I faced. And it is called as Back in Control, A Woman's Journey of Managing Unexpected Changes. Mm-hmm. From the very beginning, I think all of us, I'm not just an exclusive person, I think all of us face our individual challenges.
Correct.
But what I learned is that when you start learning from your own challenges that you face, your life actually becomes beautiful. Most of them have this problem of talking about their past because they think that my past is not that glamorous, my past is not that great, my past is not that, inspirational.
Yeah.
But for me, I would say that my life has been inspirational for me as well, for me. And there was a time, point in time, that I stopped looking at inspirations from others and I started taking inspiration from my own life. Because I said, if I can share my story to others, mm-hmm. I'm sure that I can do something in my own life, right? So challenges are immense, immense. And one of the challenges that I'd like to talk about is losing my dad when I was 21 years old. And this was exactly on my birthday that I lost him.
Oh, no.
That was the last day I saw him. And 1 week after that, I lost him. Mm-hmm. And this has been a turning point in my life. And my book actually revolves around the whole trauma that I went through because of this unprecedented incident in my life. Mm-hmm. And how I overcame that. So life is not just one challenge that I faced. It's some of many challenges that I faced. But how I actually handled it determines what I do in the future. And that's exactly what I'm sharing with you now.
Yeah. Is your book out in the markets? People can buy it?
Yes, absolutely. It's available on Amazon as well as in Kindle version, Apple book, and paperback version as well. So you can always go into Amazon and see, and this book is available. So this is what it is.
Back to control.
Yeah. Back in control. Yes. Okay, back in control.
Great. So we know about your challenges now. We know about your success strategy now. Any advices would you like to share with our audience today?
What I would say is that there are a few things that you need to do when you are in a situation like this, which is not exclusive to someone else or me. You know, we're all in the same boat.
Yeah.
One of the things that we can do is obviously have people in your life. Your relationships are very important at this time. There may be incidents where people probably would not pick up your call because you've lost your job and you may have difficulty in reaching out to people. Yet, this is the time that you have to find avenues where you can have a support system. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm not only saying support system in a monetary manner, even talking to someone. Like, for example, typically where I was, Toastmasters was a very good platform for me to actually break open my challenges as well.
Yeah.
So have people with you. That could be your family. That could be your own network that you have. That is an important thing. Mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to reach out to people, right?
Yeah.
People usually keep their emotions within themselves. And what you're doing now, Jason, is a fantastic thing. You're reaching out to people. You're talking to people to know their stories, right?
Yeah.
And don't be afraid to speak out. You may have your own story, and most of the trouble comes from because of your internal struggles that you have. And the more you keep and bottle it inside you, you will not be able to overcome that. So don't be scared. So have one or two people with you who you can actually share your struggles with.
Mm-hmm.
So your network, reach out to people and share your stories, share your emotions with people.
Yeah, I think those are the most realistic advices you can give.
Yes. Yeah. Rest will fall in place, and keep trying, keep moving.
Yeah.
You may have a very bad day, yet that's not the reason for you to stop doing what you're doing. Because when you are pursuing your passion, you will understand that there is no end to passion. I mean, there is no good day or bad day to passion. So when I was in the worst of my state, sometimes mental state, I would still deliver some speeches, and that actually helped me to, you know, come out of my emotional state that I was in.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say, identify your passion, pursue that passion.
Yes.
It's easy to say, but then because I practiced it, I'm able to tell you realistically that pursue your passion. That helps you come out of a lot of trouble that you have.
Great. Thanks a lot, Ms. Jyotika, for this time. Hope you get published and release lots of books, and we could see you in the best-selling authors, in the line of best-selling authors.
Certainly, definitely.
God bless all your projects. God bless your family, and have a great day. Have a great, successful life ahead. Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you very much for having me.